Hello and welcome to Jacinto 7 training on Processor SDK for automotive applications. Processor SDK contains various software components which will allow you to develop and deploy your applications onto Jacinto 7 family of SoCs. My name is Kedar and I am the software architect of Processor SDK. In this session, you will get a brief overview of the SDK. So let's get started. Processor SDK Automotive for Jacinto 7 is TI's common software development kit, which spans across the Jacinto 7 family of SoCs. You can use this SDK to develop various automotive-specific applications like ADAS applications for surround view, park assist, sensor fusion, front camera, as well as gateway applications, IO hub, and infotainment applications. Processor SDK consists of two installer packages, one for developing Linux side applications and another for developing RTOS side applications. In a typical end application, both Linux and RTOS side packages are needed. For example, most applications will have some software running on ARM Cortex-R5, the C66 or C7X DSP. This needs the RTOS SDK. The RTOS SDK is complemented by Linux running on ARM Cortex-A72. Linux is included as part of the Linux SDK. Together, the Linux and RTOS SDK provide all the baseline software that is needed to access various hardware features on Jacinto 7. This allows you to focus on your specific application without having to understand all the low-level details of the SoC and software. Additionally, on the ARM Cortex-A72, you can replace Linux with third-party OS like QNX or Green Hills Integrity OS. Let us now take a closer look at the Linux and RTOS SDK software stack. Jacinto 7 SoC consists of multiple heterogeneous CPUs like ARM and DSP. Each CPU is targeted to perform specific optimized functions. All CPUs collaborate together to realize the final end application. Linux SDK runs on ARM Cortex-A72, while RTOS SDK runs on other CPUs like the ARM Cortex-R5, C66 DSP and C7X DSP. The SDK itself can be represented as a layered software architecture. At the bottommost layer, we have the bootloader. Bootloader is used to boot various CPUs out of reset and start running the Linux OS or the RTOS application. U-boot is used as the bootloader for Linux. U-boot is also used for booting RTOS CPUs early in the boot flow. TI additionally also provides a bare metal bootloader as part of the RTOS SDK. This can be used by third-party OS vendors, or in some cases, it can also be used to fast boot Linux and RTOS CPUs. Next, we have the OS itself. This consists of Linux kernel and optionally a hypervisor on A72. On the DSPs and R5Fs, we have the TI RTOS called SysBIOS. Just above the OS is the Interprocessor Communication Library, also referred to as IPC. IPC allows the various software applications on different CPUs to synchronize and exchange messages among each other. This message exchange is done using a common shared memory and interrupts to help reduce message passing overheads and latency. Next, we have the various device drivers for different CPUs. On Linux, you get the usual Linux kernel drivers like UART, Ethernet, PCI, USB, as well as specific hardware accelerator drivers for multimedia and graphics. On the RTOS side, the SDK contains various peripheral drivers as part of the Platform Development Kit or PDK. The RTOS SDK also contains computer vision and deep learning libraries to accelerate your CNN and deep learning applications. AUTOSAR MCAL is also provided on ARM R5F to help develop AUTOSAR applications. To speed up application development on a heterogeneous SoC, the SDK also provides middleware libraries like OpenVX for ADAS applications, OpenGL for graphics, and GStreamer for multimedia. OpenVX runs on RTOS CPUs and allows to access RTOS functions for deep learning, camera, and hardware accelerators from A72. The various middlewares abstract the heterogeneous nature of the SoC and present a unified and simplified view for the Linux A72 applications. Finally, the SDK also provides demo applications which shows how to integrate the various software components and build automotive-specific applications. Specifically, the RTOS SDK contains demos showing surround view and deep learning analytics. Gateway demos show the usage of Ethernet switch and CAN peripheral, and integrated MCU demos on ARM R5F show safety MCU and fast CAN response time demos. The RTOS SDK also contains compilers and codegen tools for ARM R5F, C6X, and C7X DSP. GCC compiler is used for Linux A72. All these components are packaged inside two self-contained Linux and RTOS SDK installers.
Thank you for watching this training. For more information, refer to the links shown. For questions about this training, go to the Processor forums at ede.ti.com.